Okay, hello, welcome to the channel. My name is Seth Potter, and today we're going to talk about the Fujifilm XF 35mm F2 WR. Right. So, this is not a technical review. I'm not a technical photographer. Okay, now that I've said that, I've owned this lens for the better part of a decade. I've shot so much with it that the better question is, what haven't I shot with it? Product, sports, weddings, portraits, documentary photography, street photography, photojournalism when I worked for my local paper briefly. This is a go-to for me. That's how good it is. My one nitpick with it, and this is kind of just a universal rule for most lenses except for more recent models, is it does get a little bit soft up close at f2. All you got to do to eliminate though is just close down to 2.8 or 4, and at that point you're going to get sharpness that rivals these newer lenses in my opinion. So, features, reasons you'd buy this over the $200 XC version, which if you can't afford this lens, then you should get the XC version because it's the exact same lens. It's just in a slightly different package. It's just wrapped in plastic instead of this nice metal, and it's not weather sealed. But weather sealing's it's nice. You don't need it all the time, you know? But yeah, landscapes, you name it, I've shot it. So, out of all the 50mm equivalent lenses in the Fujifilm ecosystem, this is the only one I own, and it will probably always be the only one I own. Because I really, other than that little softness up close, other than that little quibble, I don't see a reason to upgrade. I just don't. I did have the 35 1.4, the original, there for a little while. Sold it to a buddy. He might let me borrow it in the future for a video. But yeah, this is the go-to lens. On these newer bodies, this new X-T5, it focuses blazing fast. I've got some video that I'll put in here somewhere to show you. My wife even still has her X-T2. She just loves the X-T2. She won't let go of it. So I popped this lens on there to give a comparison between an older X-T2 and this new camera, the X-T5, just to show you how quickly and how snappy this lens is at focusing. Yeah. What else is there to say? Weather sealed. I think I said that already. It's lightweight. It's small. I mean, look at it. Look at it. Oh, and it's pretty too, isn't it? I think it is. Can you believe this lens is 8 years old? You probably don't believe I've done everything I said I've done with it. It looks so new. It looks like I just took it out of the box, doesn't it? Yeah. Ah, pretty. A lot of people don't like this tapered design that Fuji gives their little F2 Fujicrons, compact primes. I like it. I think it's unique. I think that they got rid of that on these newer. This is the 23 1.4 LMWR, the new one. It looks like a Coke can to me. You know, it's just tube. Not that there's anything wrong with that. The images these new lenses put out are phenomenal. But this is close. You want comparable sharpness, drop it down to 2.8 or 4. Use a flash, you know. Quality of light affects sharpness a lot, believe it or not. Almost more than the lens. Almost. At least I think it does. That's my opinion. That might not be factually true, but again, not a technical review, not a technical photographer. I trust this lens. always been there for me when I've needed a lens. It's never gone down on me. Never betrayed me. And I never thought that 8 years ago when I bought this lens, I never thought I'd still have it and still love it to this very day. Bought and sold many a Fujifilm lens, and this is the one that'll never go anywhere. As long as I have a Fujifilm camera body, I will have this lens. Okay, well, I think that about rounds this review up. Just checking my notes over here. Okay, yeah. In short, I think if you are looking for a 50mm equivalent lens and you can't afford the newest, greatest 33 1.4, this is a good option. It's an excellent option, actually. And if you can't afford this lens, but you want the same optical quality and the same, literally the same everything other than the outer shell, the XC35 F2 is $200. If that lens had existed when I bought this one, I'd probably be doing a review on that lens right now. And I'd probably be telling you the same thing, except for about that lens, because they are the same lens, except for the external. I also think the XC does not have an aperture ring. I'm not sure. I'm not 100% on that one, but yeah. Anyway, thank you for watching. I really appreciate it. I hope that you've enjoyed the photography that I've put up. And I'm not trying to convince you to buy this lens. If you're new to the Fujifilm ecosystem, yes, buy this lens. But if you're not, if you already have lenses and you don't have this one, you already have a 30, you already have a 50 millimeter equivalent, you already have a 35 f1.4 or the new 33 1.4, you don't need this one. You know? If you've got money to burn on photography and you already have lenses and gear, you're already all set up, buy a printer, buy a photo printer. Yep. All right. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoyed my extremely not scientific review of this lens. It's simply my 8 years of experience with it. Yeah. Phenomenal little lens. I've beaten it up and it looks new. I can't get over it. It's so pretty. It's one of my favorite things about Fujifilm stuff is that it looks pretty. Okay, well, anyway, I've tried to end this video maybe 3 times, but I really like this lens. And I think that if you're a Fujifilm photographer and you're looking to buy a 50mm equivalent and you don't already have one, this is probably the one you should get. Okay. Bye.